Tell Governor Newsom to sign that bill.
The assembly overwhelmingly voted in favor in support of this bill. Bipartisans, Republicans, Democrats. How often do you see that in this country today? Very rare, but they appreciate the concern of safety, the concern of job loss. What are we going to do? We're going to lose more jobs and have more people homeless out on the street in California? Hell no. 75% of Californians support this bill, Republicans, Democrats alike. Gavin, pull your head out of your ass.
We're going to be strong, we're going to show our unity, and we're going to let this governor know that he needs to make the right decision. He needs to stand with working people. He needs to stand with drivers. He needs to stand with our communities, our safety. He needs to stand with human beings and not with those greedy tech companies who don't give a damn about our safety, who don't give a damn about our jobs. So Governor Newsom's going to have to decide, which side are you on? Which side are you on, Governor? He's going to have to decide that. So we're very fortunate today because this is top priority for our entire Teamsters union and for the whole labor movement. Very fortunate to have with us a great leader in our union, Tom Erickson, who came, not only came, but he brought his truck with him from Teamsters Local 120.
Thank you, Jason. Hey, you guys know this. Everywhere we go across the country, Sean and Fred are preaching that we gotta stick together, no matter what union or where you come from, and they prove that every single day. They're gonna get behind the wheel of the truck and do what we do. I'm a warehouse guy, I'm not a truck driver, but we all fight the same fight every single day, no matter what union you're in. I wanna give a shout out to all the drivers, all the workers, all the SAG, all the workers that are willing to fight every single day. Hats off to you. And I will say this. Remember one thing, when you're in the labor movement, you should be keeping score. You should be keeping score of the politicians that are on your side and the politicians that are not. And the ones that are not on your side, we need to vote them the fuck out of office right now. So I will leave you with this. As we go, it doesn't matter what the fight is and where we are and who we are and what we look like. At the end of the day, the labor movement's on the rise. This is our fucking time.
My name is Barry Anderson. I'm a Teamster at Local 856 out the Bay Area. I'm from Sacramento. I heard supporting the driverless car. I heard supporting why we need more drivers in the cars out there in the Bay Area, all over Sacramento.
Robo taxis, they want to get rid of drivers.
All over the state. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Man. Wow.
But why is this in fight important to all working people? I mean, it seems like...
It just seems like they're trying to kill the working class, the proletariat. That's what it seems like. So we got to stand and fight. If we don't stand and fight, who will? We got future generations. We got children. We got kids. The next group of workers is going to come after us. Now it's time to fight all over the country. The UAW workers, everybody, if you hear me right now, working class, union, non-union, unite, divided we fall, but united, we stand.
Lindsay Doherty, International Brotherhood of Teamsters, Teamsters Local 399 out of Hollywood, California.
So much for being here.
We're here to encourage our governor to do the right thing and sign a bill called AB 316, which requires a human safety operator in autonomous vehicles over 10,000 pounds, which is a huge safety concern for our communities, as well as the working people in the state of California for our jobs. So we're hearing that the governor is not willing to support working people, to support safety in the community, and does not want to sign the bill and will veto it. So that's why we're here to encourage him to do the right thing.
And Governor Newsom says he's for working people. If he signs his bill, what does that say to you?
Well, then he's in the step of the right direction, but the fact that we have to rally for that right now is a problem. But we're hearing that he's not going to sign it. We'll see. If he signs it, then he's on the path to redemption.
And AI, are you concerned about artificial intelligence and how it'll affect your members?
I think everyone should be concerned about artificial intelligence just because there's so much unknown about it, which is what Governor Newsom said to CNN just yesterday. But, you know, we have a concern, obviously, as union people and working people that our jobs are going to be displaced. And look, if we're not against progress, but we have to be part of this conversation about what is your strategy, how are you going to replace these jobs? Because we've seen what's happened time and time again when jobs have gone overseas and have left America, and middle of America is left with nothing. So that's what we're
doing. Isn't that one of the reasons they're developing AI to get rid of workers?
I mean,
replace workers?
I think it's to increase their profits as well. It's a business. And so, of course, they want to reduce labor and increase their profits. So, you know, we understand capitalism, but again, you have to make sure that we're taking care of the people that made this country, built this country, and also are your voters.
My name is Ruth Rhodes. I'm a member of APW and also the Secretary Treasurer of Five Counties Central Labor Council. And we're here to support this bill that was a bipartisan bill, AB 316, for safety on our streets. The biggest issue we've got with this driverless vehicles is the technology is super new. Most of the vehicles on the street are not driverless, and so they're not coordinated, and it's very dangerous to have these large conveyances, whether it's a bus or a truck, out there roaming the streets with no driver, and they often weigh 80,000 pounds. So we're here to support this bill.
And it seems like AI, a lot of companies would like to use it to get rid of workers. Are you concerned about that?
Oh, very concerned about that. And we have been for quite a while.
And what's happening with the APW? Are you facing that as well, automation, robotics? And
well, they could possibly automate all our trucks that go from Sacramento to the smaller processing centers and all the other centers all across the nation. So yes, all of our MVS drivers would be affected, and also we are experiencing automation taking over jobs already in the last 15 to 20 years.
Well, nothing is wrong with automation. Technology can't stop it, but who is it going to benefit? I think that's the question. Benefit working people, the public, or somebody else?
It benefits the public in some ways because it allegedly makes the processing more efficient. But in the end, there's always a trade-off. And if you're trading off lives or people's physical, you know, safety, is that worth it? Is that worth that little bit more of efficiency that you might get?
And you think that the labor movement, I mean, the actors, the writers are on strike, partly over AI being replaced, replacing healthcare workers, doctors. I mean, it seems like there's a trend to automate and use AI to really get rid of millions. Goldman Sachs said 350 million workers may lose their jobs globally. It seems like the future is very dangerous if this is introduced without any kind of control.
When you have a lot of people who are unemployed with time on their hands, that can get very dangerous. And especially people who are educated. Not just the people who do the manual work, but also your educated people that could coordinate them.
You don't see a future the way things are going.
So this is going to be a very dangerous time if we continue to allow AI to take over the workforce and not have some replacement for people to do actual work and earn a living and have some meaning in their lives. I don't know about you, but I don't want my money handed to me. I do like to produce something and be creative and make something. So I would like to be able to still earn a living with something that I make, create, or a service I provide to another person.
And the UAW, one of their demands is 32-hour work week or 40 hours pay. With electric vehicles coming in, it could wipe out 40% of their membership. Do you think a shorter work week is an issue around automation?
It probably is going to end up that way. I don't know that I could see it not becoming that. There's a bunch of people that feel like you have to work 40, 50, 60 hours. Or even just one job. And I was in one of those. Because they feel like they own you. Well, we're not slaves. We are free people. And so in America, we still have some of this mentality that the people who are in charge can exploit the people who get the work done. But without the people getting the work done, those people don't have a product or a service to offer to the public. And they're also, what are they doing to build communities? How are we all connected together? We build something together as a group of people. We have a purpose together. But as individuals, we're just wandering around. We don't have that sense of purpose for each other. So to maintain the democracy in America, you also have to have a community of people. And part of what we do together to build our communities and create a more livable lifestyle than we had 300, 400 years ago, okay, that's what we've been doing together. So What is our future? That is our question. And what is AI going to bring to this future?
My name is Roman Berry, and I'm out here to support AB 316 because I'm a driver and I want safe streets. And I want people to make sure, I want to make sure that when there is a vehicle on the road that somebody's there to make a better decision than an AI that hasn't been trained properly. And that's the danger of this. It's just that we could be in a situation where we're experimenting with our streets and there are people walking.
Using people's guinea pigs.
Yeah, that's the
San Francisco with the robo taxi.
Yeah, no, and I mean, like, you got a situation already. You see the Waymo vehicle stopping in the middle of the street, or
I mean, it should be illegal. You're supposed to follow the vehicular code, but it seems they're not enforcing the vehicular code when they.
Yeah, no, you're right. I mean, it's not only that. It's just that you can also play games with these vehicles. You can put a cone on top of them and stop them in the middle of the street. What's to say that that doesn't become a trend on TikTok and kids start doing that all over? You know, and that can be quite dangerous. You could have a traffic jam. There could be somebody who needs to get to the hospital on time and they're, you know, they're stuck. It's just a dangerous game. And I mean, I don't have any problem with, you know, technology, but it needs to be tried and tested before it's put out to the masses. And I mean, like, I don't have kids yet, but I plan to have some, and I don't want, you know, somebody to use them as guinea pigs and then get potentially getting hit.
Well, I mean, it sounds like the politicians are taking a lot of money from the tech billionaires.
Yeah.
Are you concerned about that's who Newsom is going to listen to? I mean, he wants to, they say that San Francisco's like as a ground central for AI and they want California to be in front, you know.
I think that this isn't the first time Newsom would be taking money from, you know, large companies. I mean, there were bills on his desk that could have given us free health care across the state.
It's a single payer, so
but he took Blue Shield's money, you know. So
it was at that dinner paid for by the hospital association.
Yeah. So we're in a situation where we're looking at politicians and we got to hold them accountable, and especially my generation who's just kind of fed up with being told what to do and not having a say in it.
My name is Mike DeBaney.
Okay. And Mike, you're here today with hundreds of Teamsters from all over California. It seems like this is a basic issue for the survival of the Teamsters union if they get rid of all these drivers. Are you concerned about that?
Actually, I would somewhat disagree with that statement. I think if this were to go ahead, if Newsom let this go through, and didn't support AB 316, the Teamster jobs are going to be at the lower end of people that are going to be affected. Anything with wheels at some point will be affected, from taxis, school bus drivers, bus drivers, package delivery drivers. We're talking Teamster jobs, which of course I'm concerned with, is a small portion of hundreds of thousands of jobs across the United States. I don't see the benefit to taking away all those jobs, making our roads unsafe.
Well, why would he put something, allow something like that, these big trucks without a driver, if it's going to affect the health and safety of working people and the roads?
Because he's termed out. You want the honest answer? Because he's termed out. I'm not gonna make statements as if there may be financial dealings. To me, politicians are bought and sold, and favors are traded, and across the board.
You think we need a labor party in this country?
Not necessarily a labor party. Labor parties in the past haven't done so well.
We've never had one in the United States.
I'm talking about the ones not in the United States. Yeah. I think we need a brand new approach, but Gavin Newsom swore to, in so many words, to protect 39 million Californians. As a truck driver, I can tell you, I drive on these roads. I've had steering tires blow out at freeway speed, and that truck will cross two or three lanes before you can even get it under control, because the physics suddenly don't work as you've been taught that they work. You need a feather touch, you need intuition, you need to be able to look down the road and see that guy staring into his mirror to know he's going to jump in front of you because he's just being an idiot.
Robo trucks are dangerous, that's what you're saying.
Having
a robot driving one of these trucks, it would be frightening.
80,000 pounds driving headlong next to me without some eyes to look into to know that you know what I'm going to do. a machine that doesn't even realize I'm a person, let alone value my life or the safety around me, that's a big problem for me. And I'd like to point out that these companies show that they have truck drivers in these vehicles, why they're using them right now to improve their code, because they feel that a human driver is key, a key safety component. But when they want to sell that technology, safety isn't much of an issue, and they pull the people right back out because they're not trying to sell safety, they're trying to sell. And it's snake oil for them to say it's safe because they don't know.
And the actors and actresses, writers are on strike, AI, healthcare workers. I mean, it seems like AI is a real serious issue for the future of labor.
I mean, it is, but AI isn't going anywhere. We have no problem with technology at all. AB 316 is the cross section between common sense, experience, human oversight, and the willingness to work with new technology, because we need technology. It's not going anywhere.
Who should it benefit? Isn't that the question? Should it benefit workers or the public or the billionaires?
It should benefit everyone. I've got no problem with billionaires making money provided they take care of their people and try to make us all more safe. I got no problem with capitalism. I just want to be safe at night, and I want to know my family on the road is safe too.
Mikey Alberton, Teamster, Local 856.
Yeah. United Airlines.
Yeah, United Airlines, yeah.
So you're here today to support this fight around robo trucks?
Yeah, I'm totally against them having driverless trucks and support a 316's bill. And I got to support my fellow union brothers. I work in a different industry, but hey, labor's labor. And right now in this country, man, you got the UAW out on strike right now. You got the theater workers out on strike. It's a big deal. I actually kind of was hoping all this would happen back in 2008, but we're here.
It sounds like it's happening now.
Yeah, time to get ready and rumble.
What's happening at United Airlines? You're here. You're a Teamster.
Well, actually, we voted in a contract extension. We're going to start negotiations by another year with the company. But we got our flight attendants right now been out without a contract. Well, amendable contract for 4 years. They've been having rallies around the country and stuff like that. Same with Alaska Airline flight attendants. The pilots recently got an agreement principle / tentative agreement out of doing road shows. And I think they got a pretty good deal. But I'm happy for them, actually. They put the heat on and having rallies, and they got stuff done with the company. So, I mean, yeah.
Workers have the power if they use it?
Absolutely. And my hats are off to the pilots. The pilots union, those guys and girls, stick together.
Well, no pilots, no flights. Yeah. If they like to automate them, you can automate these planes.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, this is just the beginning. They automate this. Like I said, next thing you have robots flying the plane or fly-by-wire. And some. Yeah, I could see it all coming. I could see it all coming. So, just bad. Especially airline industry. It's also like with the airport workers that make all the operation at the airport work. You got the food workers, people at custodians. They've been getting paid dirt wages. They're constantly fighting for some dignity and respect.
How do you live in the Bay Area with the cost of living?
I don't know how it is. I'm still renting an apartment, right? And I don't know how people do it. They got multiple roommates. Some people got crash pads. That ain't no way to live, though.
You can't even have a family. You're stuck in.
No, you're stuck. You're stuck. Yeah, I know people that are crammed into an apartment with some kids and stuff, and it just ain't right. Yeah.
People should have a decent life.
Absolutely, and having a good, when you work full time like that, you should have affordable housing.
Robot trucks have got to go. Hey, hey, ho, ho. Robot trucks have got to go. Hey, hey, ho, ho. Robot trucks have got to go. Hey, hey, ho, ho.
Thank you. Robots got to go.
We are calling on Governor Newsom to do the right thing. We are calling on Governor Newsom to sign AB 316 to make sure that there is a human safety operator, otherwise known as a truck driver, a professional, safe, licensed truck driver in the cab of that truck to make sure that we are safe.
I'm Lauren. I'm with the North Valley Labor Federation. I'm an organizer. This is Sal.
And you're up from North Hollywood. This issue of robotics, AI, it seems like it's a growing issue for working people.
Yes, definitely. It's not fair that our creativity is being taken away and like trying to be replaced, and you can't replace that with, you can't replace human expression and feelings with robots, and it's like, it's ridiculous. People have done this for all their lives, and we just stand in support with the Writers Guild and everything. So I don't know, Sal, if you want.
No, I completely agree. When you see the profits that the companies are making, it's all due to labor and their workers. So just give credit back to the workers and give them a fair wage, right? We want to give recognition to these workers, because without them, these companies wouldn't be where they're at now. So.
Yeah, I mean, well, 350 million jobs may be in jeopardy. Goldman Sachs did a study. It's a large number of jobs. It seems like young people are waking up and joining unions. They're complaining about that. Are you surprised about the fact that young people see a future by you joining the union?
You know, it's actually kind of exciting. I'm not surprised, but I'm more excited. We've seen this with the Starbucks unionized campaigns. We've seen it with the Amazon unionized campaigns. So I feel like it's kind of like being, you know, more accepting nowadays. Like, I know that it used to be really, you know, frowned upon when you did talk about unions maybe 10 to 20 years ago, but now I feel like it's a lot getting, not where we're at, but it's getting a lot stronger now.
This rally had people from throughout California and nationally. You think working people are getting together?
I love it. It's solidarity. So we need to see more of it.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Oh, what's your
name? My name is Salvador Valencia. I'm an organizer with the North Valley Labor Federation. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. And I'll say, I didn't even know what a union was growing up. None of my families were part of unions or anything. I didn't understand like that was even possible. And I actually was a Starbucks worker. Sal's been in retail. We all have this experience where we're like working so hard and we don't see the same benefits as our previous generation did. So we're seeing climate change and all these things, like we want a better future, and we're not seeing it for ourselves right now, and that's why we're joining the movement. And it's really exciting seeing people even younger than us and everything like join. So
if he does not sign the bill, are there going to be retribution by labor?
Well, I think what he has to know is we're not done. It's not a flash in the pan. This is something that we're going to continue to push. We're going to continue to bring up. We're going to continue to work on. And if he doesn't sign it, we'll bring it right back next year, because this is an existential threat to all of our jobs.
Well, isn't it possible to get an override with the kind of vote you have?
That's up to the legislature. I haven't seen them override, and it's a little difficult.
They could. They have the vote.
Technically, they could, but you would also have to get them back in session in a certain amount of days. The technical requirement is a little tough. Yeah.
And the Democrats, even a Republican, are behind this bill. Do you think the people of California are really getting worried about AI and how it can affect the future of workers?
We know that that's happening, because in every poll that we have seen, people are stating that they don't want like driverless trucks, that they are worried that their own jobs could be replaced with robots. People want to make sure that we're having a discussion about workers' lives and the future of workers.
And the California Public Utility zoning commission voted to allow robo taxis in San Francisco. The Department of Motor Vehicles say it's okay to have these cars. They violate the vehicle code every day. Why are these agencies, which are supposed to be protecting people, allowing this robo technology?
You know, that's a great question. And that's why we need to have this bill and not just leave it up to these agencies. Like royalty, royalty.